a film in 3 minutes, Office Space. Hey folks, what's happening? Listen, we're gonna need to take a look at your TPS reports, okay? Yeah, did you get that memo? If you're anything like 99% of the world's population, then you'll know what I mean when I say work sometimes can really suck. And luckily for us, actor, writer, animator, producer, and director Mike Judge felt exactly the same way when he made his 1999 cult comedy, Office Space. The story follows Peter Gibbons, played by Ron Livingston, a depressed, directionless cubicle worker at the American software firm Inatech, who struggles on a daily basis to endure his supercilious boss Bill Lumberg, played by Gary Cole. After being hypnotized by an occupational hypnotherapist, who incidentally dies from a heart attack before completing his trance, Peter is reborn and no longer plagued by the hatred of his job, becoming zen-like in his nihilism and quickly moving through the upper ranks of Inatech with zero effort. Office Space's development began with a series of animated short films created by Judge for Saturday Night Live that feature the titular character of Milton Waddams, who would be played magnificently by Stephen Root in the feature film. The many scenes of Peter and his co-workers struggling with the day-to-day doldrums of office life resonate with anyone who has experienced humdrum office work themselves, but thematically, Office Space works as a searing critique of the modern American dream and the management tactics that come with it, such as when Inatech bring in a pair of business consultants to help the company downsize, forcing everyone at Inatech to re-interview for their own jobs. Frustration too comes from the broken office equipment the workers have to endure, as well as joyless birthdays and soulless company initiatives.
Friday is Hawaiian shirt day.
The interplay Peter has with his two most trusted colleagues, Samir Nainanajar and the unfortunately named Michael Bolton, end up giving us some of the film's most iconic moments, particularly when Peter steals a malfunctioning printer for the sake of revenge. The film's small budget and poor marketing would make Office Space a box office bomb, but thanks to home video and DVD sales, the film quickly developed a cult following, with many of the characters' dialogue and plot devices entering pop culture.
Come on, let's go fill out those TPS reports so we can go recharge the power coil.
Stephen Root's portrayal of the before-mentioned Milton steals the show whenever he's on screen, mumbling quietly in protest each time his desk is moved or has his beloved swingline stapler taken away from him. Such was the success of the stapler's appearance in the film that fans petitioned the company to reissue a red version of their stapler, which they finally did in 2002. The depiction of unhappy workers, arrogant bosses, and cold-hearted capitalism makes Office Space one of the most relatable comedies of the last 30 years, and despite an ever-evolving working environment, which could make large-scale offices one day redundant, Peter's central arc revolving around taking a chance on life and not letting your job completely define who you are will resonate with any viewer. Unless, of course, that viewer is Bill Lumberg. Yeah.